Good morning. It's Tuesday, June 2nd, 2020. I'm Russell, and this is Rocky Road Devotions, a few minutes of help for today's journey. Our devotion today is entitled, Violence in the Land, and our scripture is Psalm chapter 11, verse 5. The Lord examines both the righteous and the wicked. He hates those who love violence. The death of George Floyd while in the custody of policeman Derek Chauvin ignited a countrywide firestorm of protests, some of which erupted into rioting, looting, and injury. The flood of blaming from both sides of another polarizing event is deafening. Some law enforcement camps are circling the wagons. Outraged citizens are calling for heads to roll. Politicians are pandering. News cycle junkies and pundits are both working the talking points to death. Meanwhile, the now fired former police officer is sitting in a maximum security cell, charged with third-degree murder and manslaughter, with a first appearance to answer the charges scheduled next week. It is entirely understandable that a community backlash would and should follow such an horrific end to a man's life. Moral, legal action is demanded to sort out not only what happened, but to seek justice when a law enforcement official with three backup officers on the scene chooses to exert force apparently sufficient to kill, particularly when the apprehended man is secured and begging for mercy. Society that quietly looks the other way from such brutality is hideously inhumane. From a personal viewpoint, I cannot get my mind to move past the thought that for George Floyd and Derek Chauvin, this was a family matter. They were brothers. Now that statement alone is liable to get me a dozen or more "Are you crazy?" responses. So let me explain. Scripture tells us we come from a common ancestor named Eve. Even for the less biblically based among us, current science proclaims her name was Lucy, or Luca, last universal common ancestor. That ultimately means George Floyd and Derek Chauvin are of the same family, which makes them both part of the same race, human. This was a family matter, even if neither of them knew it. It's important to note that the very first murder recorded in Scripture is perpetrated by the first human to be born on Earth. God had put Cain's parents together by hand. They never saw the inside of a neonatal unit. Cain and Abel were instructed what kind of offering to bring to give thanks to God for their lives. Abel listened and was obedient. Cain didn't and wasn't. When God called him on his poor choice, Cain got ticked, and since he knew he couldn't wrestle with God and come out on top, he took his anger out on his brother with a rock to the head. And brothers have been using rocks, clubs, guns, spears, swords, and smart bombs to carry on the family tradition ever since. Now that's bad enough, but enter the rioters and looters. In a kind of Cain profile, some are just drawn by the lure of the mob. Somehow it's a safe place to take revenge for injustice. And people do love a safe place from which to proclaim self-righteously their anger. And if being anonymous in a mob you can get away with smashing a store window, you might as well take that 72-inch smart TV home too. We have a word to describe that. It's called cowardice. In the end, we all play Cain's card. It's somebody else's fault. After all, Cain learned it best from his and his brother's parents. When they sinned, God demanded an accounting, and here's how that played out in Genesis chapter 3. The Lord God called to the man, "Where are you?" He replied, "I heard you walking in the garden, so I hid. I was afraid because I was naked." "Who told you that you were naked?" the Lord God asked. "Have you eaten from the tree whose fruit I commanded you not to eat?" The man replied, "It was the woman you gave me who gave me the fruit and I ate it." Then the Lord God asked the woman, "What have you done?" "The serpent deceived me," she replied. "That's why I ate it." Deflect, blame someone else, hide, don't show your face. It's the blame game. Only in the case of George Floyd, it wasn't much of a game. Let's pray together. Father, our hearts and souls are pierced once again at the madness of violence we have in our land. There seems to be no end of anger and fingers pointing at each other. We play the blame game with an amazing and continually increasing disastrous effects. And then we go to church on Sunday to worship the goodness of the Prince of Peace. You cannot be pleased with your children and our ungrateful, unfaithful, brutal ways. May our hearts be pierced with your love. May it extend to our brothers. For you today, brutality and revenge. When have two wrongs ever made right? You chew on that as you hit the rocky road today. Have a blessed day.